Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can create a text field in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Okay, everybody, we're going to be creating a JTextField. This is a GUI text box component that can be used to add, set, or get some text. So imagine you're logging into a website and you type in your username and password. Well, those boxes are perfect examples of text boxes. We're also going to create a submit button so that when we enter in a username, we can submit whatever text we enter in. But we're going to implement an action listener, so it's best if we create a new class to do this. So within my source folder, I'm going to go to File, New, Class, and I will call this class MyFrame. MyFrame will extends JFrame, so it's going to behave exactly as a JFrame. This will also implement the action listener interface so that this frame can listen for events like a button click when we want to submit a username. So make sure to add all of these imports. And since we're implementing an interface, we need to add any unimplemented methods. So make sure to add public void action performed. We're also going to create a constructor for this class, so myFrame. And we have to go through the motions of setting up a frame. I'm going to copy and paste this. So you just type in this.setDefaultClosedOperation, JFrame exit on close. We're going to use a flow layout for this example, so make sure you use a flow layout. You can also set this to null if you want, but you have to manually place your components. We're going to pack this frame so that the size of the frame will adjust to fit the components that you add, and then finish this up with this.setVisibleTrue. And then we have to create an instance of this frame. So we'll say myFrame frame equals new myFrame. Let's head back to our myFrame class, and we're going to create a JTextField. So JTextField, we'll call this textField, equals new JTextField. Field. And we'll need an import for this. Import JTextField. And let's set some dimensions for this text field. So text field dot set preferred size. And we'll pass in a new dimension. Let's say 250 by 40. So 250 for the width and 40 for the height. And we'll need an import for dimension. Now we need to add this text field to our frame. So make sure you add this before you actually pack the frame. So this dot add, we're adding our text field. And we should have a text field now within our frame, which we do. And we can type in text like this. What if we want to submit some text? We'll probably want a button. So let's create a button to the left-hand side of this text field. So J button, we'll call this button, equals new J button. And we can set some text right away too. Let's say submit. And we're going to add this button to our frame. So this.add button. Now you notice we have a submit button, but it currently doesn't do anything. So we need to add an action listener. So let's do that here. Button.addActionListener. Since this class is implementing an action listener interface, we can simply just pass in this. And when this frame detects an event, we can check to see if that event is the button. So if e.getSource is equal to our button, we're going to do something. We're going to take our text field dot get text. Okay, but let's take a look at this. Our button and our text field are not recognized. That's because we declared our button and text field within the constructor, so they're only local to the constructor. We need to declare these outside of the constructor so that they're global. So we'll copy this and paste it. JButton button, that's all we need, as well as JTextField text field. So here we're declaring this twice. We don't need to do that. Since we declared these components outside of the constructor, they are now global so that this action performed method now has access to them. So make sure to take out JButton for the button and JTextField for the text field. And now these should be recognized. All right, so we're going to use this method, getText, to retrieve whatever text is within our text box, our text field. So let's print out a message. I'm going to surround this with a print line statement. So we could say maybe welcome plus whatever the text is that somebody types in. Let's try this. So let's say we enter in our username, bro code, and click submit. It says welcome bro code. Let's customize the appearance of this text field. Well, because we can. So let's begin by changing the font. So text field dot set font, and we can pass in a new font and pick whatever font you want. I will pick Consolas, and then we can say font dot plain or bold or italic. And then we can also pick a font size. So I will pick 35. 35 is a good number. And let's take a look. That's pretty sweet. Let's change the font color. So we do that with set foreground, text field dot set foreground. And we can pass in a color like color dot green, or we can pass in some RGB values or a hex value. So we can do that with new color. And I'm just going to use a hex value this time. You can look these up online. That is for green 0x00FF00. So this is a bright green color. Sweet. Let's change the background color. So text field dot set background, and we can pass in like a preset color or a new color. I'm just going to turn this to black. So color dot black. And now we have a black J text field. But you can see that the caret, that's that line that is blinking. It's a little difficult to see. We can actually change the color of that as well. So text field dot set caret, well, set caret color, then we can pass in a color. So I will pick color dot white. And this caret, this line, when you type in something, is now visible. Let's set the text of our text field. So text field dot set text, and we pass in a string. We could place the string username here so that somebody knows to type in their username. So it just says username, but you can edit this and type in whatever you want. Hacker123. If for some reason you need to prevent somebody from editing this text field, you can do so with the set editable method. So we type in the name of the text field, dot set editable, and we can set this to false so that when set editable is set to false, we can no longer edit this text field, even though I'm trying really hard to do so. Here's an idea. What if we disabled the text field as well as this button after we submit a username? So within this action performed method, we're going to get rid of this line, textField.setEditableFalse, place this within our action performed method, and let's also disable that button as well. So button.setEnabled, and we'll set this to false. So that after we submit a username, like hacker123, and click submit, we can no longer submit another username. So that's an option that's also available to you. So yeah, that's the basics of creating J text fields in Java. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of creating a J text field in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.